Hello, Christ Legacy. It seems that we meet through video all the time, which excites me to tell you that I'm going to be glad to be with everybody on this coming Sunday at 10:30. What a day we've lived through, and it's still not over, and we don't really know what all the future is, but I just wanted to come and give you some information that it, as well as we can plan to this moment, and you might want to get a pen or paper, jot this down, or you can come back and watch the video later. I want to cover the next three or four or five Sundays just to give you an idea. Last week, like we gave you, so that you can plan ahead, and we'll make the best of a tough situation. So let me just begin with this coming Sunday morning. We will be here at Church on the Lot. That means church on the parking lot. I have a list of things that I want to share with you to make sure that you have them. So here's something. If you need to hear it again, you can come back and watch the video a second time. First of all, again, on parking lot 10:30 this coming Sunday, which is May the 10th. We want to see all of you here in your cars. We're going to have a good time having church on the parking lot. Number one is your safety, and we want to be sure that we make a safe environment for everyone. We will ask you to observe social distancing, as we have called it the last few weeks, and we'll ask you to adhere to that. Masks are not mandatory, they are optional. If you want to wear a mask, you can wear a mask. If you don't want to wear a mask, that's up to you. Restrooms will be available on our west side, the south door. We call it the office entry. I'm sure you're familiar with it, or where entry to our children's church there on the west end of the building. I will tell you this, the safety team will be on the parking lot and in the building. They will assist you in any way that we can to make all of this go smoothly. Next is, the building will be sanitized on Saturday evening, so you can rest assured if you need to come into the facilities that it'll be taken care of. We're doing everything we can to make sure that it is a good environment and a safe environment for everyone. We are going to serve coffee and donuts. The donuts will be individually wrapped. We'll come and let one person with a mask and gloves on serve coffee to everyone. And we'll have to still do the social distancing thing, but we are going to have the coffee and donuts, and we're assured it'll be a safe way to handle that. Sadly, we are not allowed to have children's church nor a nursery. So those of you who have children and you want to come to the church service, maybe you should bring coloring books or toys of something to, I don't know, just help your children through a church service. If I can't imagine them not wanting to listen to Pastor Brooks preach, but they might. Anyway, service will be live. Don't forget, it'll be live on Facebook. And let me tell you, for the children following the service, we'll give you time to go eat lunch when you leave here or go home, whatever. But Pastor DJ will have a children's church at 12:30 p.m., which is right after lunch, of course, for all the children. You can get him on our website and access it from there. I want to share with you that when you arrive Sunday, the parking lot, the south parking entrance only, will be open. The entrance up by the main entry of the portico will not be open, but we will of course open it when service is over. We're doing this to put the traffic to the west side so that everyone can have a good place to view the service. If you want to stay in your car, you need to stay pretty much to the east of the parking or up close in front. If you want to get out, bring your lawn chair. You're allowed to sit on the lawn chairs or even on the parking lot. Those of you that want to stay in your car, you'll need to secure a place more up front. We ask all of you who are going to be bringing lawn chairs to park on the west side and carry your chairs to the parking lot or the lawn. If you have questions, need some communication at all about anything this Sunday, please call the office or contact us online, and we'll be glad to help you. One further thing, we'd like to ask some of you to, once service is over, our staff has had to work overtime many hours to prepare to set this all up, and they could, following the end of service, could sure use some help taking up cables and cameras and sound equipment and musical instruments, all that. Be sure to see Pastor Dave, Pastor John, or Pastor Henry to help us do that. It'd be much appreciated. Let's look at Wednesday evenings just for a minute. because people 65 years of age are asked not to meet, we will think it's probably best that we cancel all of our services through May on Wednesday evening. But I will tell you this, at 7 p.m. we will be on Facebook. Myself or Brother Martin will be there to minister. The youth are on Facebook also, and I think they're on Instagram, other means by which they communicate every Wednesday at 7 p.m. So young people will have a service, the adults will have a service. So that kind of catches us up until a week from Sunday. Looking ahead, on May the 17th at 10:30, one service, we will return to our sanctuary. The biggest thing we'll have to do is, of course, with the large number, we'll have to observe the social distancing. And again, the protocol of a mask is up to you, but we'll be inside the sanctuary. To remind you, the sanctuary, the entire building will be sanitized Saturday evening before. Again, we're not allowed yet to have a nursery, no children's church. But again, Pastor DJ will be online each week afterward for the children. That's May 17, first time back in our building. May 24, we'll have a 10:30 service in the sanctuary. Again, we'll have it sanitized. Again, no nursery, no children's church, but it'll be online the 24th. The sad news about what I had planned was that, of course, is Memorial Day weekend. I cannot get access to enough meat to make a time for a picnic so that we can cook for you as we planned. Just can't make it happen. And so for right now, we're just going to have to cancel what I'd planned for a picnic on Memorial Day. We'll leave that to you and your family. We will have service that morning at 10:30, but no picnic afterwards. I'm sure you understand. So we'll reschedule something along that line at a later date. On the 31st of May, we'll have our final single service in the sanctuary. Again, it'll be sanitized, the protocol, as it changes, I think, as of Friday or something. Then we look over in June, which starts our next month, and as the protocol permits, we plan on returning to two services on June the 7th. And then we will make an announcement and decisions about Wednesday evenings, depending on what the guidelines are for us. Well, I hope that helps you with dates and times. I know it's a lot to remember, but again, you can contact the office or contact us and we'll help you stay on schedule or any questions you have. I want you to know that I want us to come Sunday. You're welcome to come, stay in your car. If you want to bring your own coffee and donuts, fine. I just would love to see all of you, and we're looking forward to Sunday. I've said it last week on this announcement. I say it again, we're going to get together next Sunday by long distance. But it'll be fun, and we'll worship the Lord, and we'll stay faithful to our church and to the Lord of the church. So until Sunday, God bless you. I'm anxious to see you.